know how many of you noticed as we were building this shoe, we were saving room for two more elements of the shoe modification display. One I was using Perkhart SSPs, which have a little extra steel provided on the outside frame. Then I also racked it slightly. You can see here where the fullering ends here and there. It's racked slightly. That's going to allow me room to do my punch nail hole here as one of the modifications. And then we're also going to add a trailer to this excess heel there. Okay, I like to punch my nail holes at a much lighter heat. This just prevents a lot of undue distortion and also keeps your tools from getting too much overheated. And the nail hole calls for it to be outside of the flooring. I'm going to punch this for MX50. Back and add a trailer over this long heel. The width of the shoe is 3/4 of an inch, so we're going to start by turning over 1 inch and make a little mark on the anvil here where we can make sure we hit that point. We've got the shoe, get our heel hot. The piece of section you need to, if you've got access to a coat fire, keep destroying your shank you've already established. We'll just make the first fan so we can get to it a little easier. And down here, grab it in line with the part you're bending. Sweet spot where we can upset this back into itself. Right there. What that's going to do is allow that corner to pop out and give us a little definition. Go back and find that spot again. Still got enough heat, you can go ahead and box it. Just take the sharp edges off. Go ahead and save it a little bit just to get rid of some of the sharp corners and then box it. top. Pretty well established, and we've still got 3/4 of an inch out there measured from the middle of the web of the shoe, and we've got it boxed.
It's regular rest. Go ahead and put the checks into that medial.
Anything else, you want to take a lot of pride in your craftsmanship, go ahead and clean these things up really nice. And one of the best ways I've found to do that is take it at a dull red heat and take a brush and dip it in water. And it really seems to clean these things up pretty nicely. If you've got plenty of heat, we'll go ahead and get it flat. And then we'll take a good look at it and make sure all the elements are there that are asked.
This is our finished product for this shoe with 3 modifications. It has the square toe. See how square? Lay a roll up against it. See how square that is. And we've got our punch nail hole. And then we've got our treader.